1 week online workshop on national FDP, LMS and e-content development. So myself, Dr. D. Antony Arulraj, working as an assistant professor come MCC officer, Department of Software System, PhD College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. So it is my great privilege to thank management of Hindustan College of Arts and Science, Principal Dr. A. Ponnayan, Dr. S. Anuradha, Convener, Hindustan Innovative Learning Hub, Professor and Head Department of Mathematics. So herewith, I would like to discuss about learning management system. So before getting into today's topic, it is very essential to know about LMS. Learning management system is a software applications. Nowadays, all the institutions were using this, which helps us in all administrative activities, documentation about the students, tracking of students, reporting, automation and delivery of educational courses, training programs or learning and development programs. The learning management system concepts emerged directly from e-learning. So here is the historical phases of education. So we have started our correspondence teaching in 1723. Then it moved on to digital multimedia teaching with digital data. So here we should know what is digital data and what is the difference between digital data and e-content. So both are similar. So digital data are nothing but, so we have to prepare our content with the help of text, audio and video. So that is called as digital data. When this digital data is added into the internet, then it becomes e-content or e-data. So then the technologies move on to telematic teaching with the support of modern telecommunication, teaching with computer-aided products. Now we are in the final, we are in the stage of internet teaching. So in this COVID-19 quarantine period, all the institutions were working through online. So it is very essential to know about many apps which are available. So what is the features of this LMS? So we can manage our course, we can manage our users such as parents and students, and we can define the roles for everyone. And it helps us in online assessments also. Next, we can track the attendance of the students. Next, we are moving to user feedback. We can get the feedbacks very easily. What is e-learning environment? E-learning environment is otherwise called as virtual learning environment. It is an educational technology, is a web-based platform for the digital aspects of courses of study within or outside the educational institute. It will create some virtual environment of teaching learning process. They present resources, activities and interaction with the course of structure and provide for the different stages of assessment. So what is the advantages of e-learning environment? There are n number of advantages are available, but few are listed here. Online learning accommodates everyone need. Here we need there are many needs between the students and teachers. These e-learning environment satisfies all the needs. And lectures can be recorded, offers access to updated content, online contents can be accessed, quick delivery of lessons, it is scalable, consistency, and it reduces the cost and it will be effective also, less impact on environment. So we, for this implementation of e-learning, we are not need of high requirements, a basic internet and the mobile or the laptop is enough to implement this. How LMS helps the academician? Since we are the academician, it is we should know how LMS is going to be help us. We can connect with all our students wherever they are. We can connect with them. May work from home. We can work from home. Assessments and tracking is very much easier in this LMS systems. Performance evaluation and comparison also done. See, comparison in the sense we can compare the students with other students, as well as we can compare the performance of the student in the previous assessments also. recorded sessions. We can record our lectures. This lectures can be helpful to the slow learners. They can recap or replay the contents which are recorded. Communicating with the parents and the communicating with administrative persons are also very much easier. Next, the maintenance of record. It is very important in our educational system. Maintenance of record is also becoming very simple. So these are the some of the benefits which we can get from LMS. So today we are going to discuss about two different applications. One is Kahoot. Kahoot is an application which makes the learning very interesting, and it provides curiosity, and we can teach them, or the students can learn with playing some playing. No matter of subject, age, or ability. This Kahoot was founded in 2012 by Martin and Johan and Jamie Broker, who are the students. They were done their joint project in Norway University of Science and Technology. They have team up with Professor Wang and later with the entrepreneur Firstet. Next, we are going to discuss about WebEx. WebEx is a product of Cisco. Cisco developed this WebEx product. There are many things are available in WebEx, but today we are going to discuss how to conduct a conference, discussions, meetings through WebEx. Why we need WebEx? In the sense, it is very much secured. And it is similar to our Zoom and Google application, but the advantages of WebEx is only it has high, simple relay. It is very much reliable and it is more secure. So before getting into the workshop, let us play a small game. Dear professors and faculty members, here I have shown some 9 dots. I hope you will be enjoying this. I hope you will be enjoying this game. So kindly, all of you, kindly take a pen and paper and draw the 9 dots. Here, there is a condition. You have to connect all the dots with 4 straight lines. And then there is a rule for you. Do not lift your hands once you start. Do not return and redraw the same line. So kindly do it. Let me give 2 minutes of time to complete this task. After that, we'll move on to the hands-on training on WebEx and Kahoot. I hope some of the professors may know this game. But it is an interesting game. So you can try more number of times to achieve the task. These 9 dots should be connected with 4 straight lines. It is the main condition. I hope some of them were done their task.
Excuse me, sir. So your PPT is not visible, sir. Excuse me, sir. Your PPT is not visible, sir.
When you start connecting these dots.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Can you hear my voice, sir?
Wait for a second.
So your PPT is not visible, sir.
I'll show the result.
Sir, Hello, sir.
Okay, so here when we start the line and if we do not exceed the points, we could not get the result. Here see that the line was started with the last below dot, and it move on to the 1, 2, 3, and you have to slightly extend your line, then only you can complete this task. This game teaches that we have to equip ourselves, improve ourselves for the today's technology. Okay, now we'll start with the Kahoot hands-on training. So for that, we'll move on to the online web. So go to the Google. Just type Kahoot. You may get the website. Here, so first of all, we have to get login inside the Kahoot. So already I have logged in. Now, this application is used to create some interactive quiz programs, which feels the students they are playing a game. So let me show you how to create and how to execute that quiz programs. You just click My Kahoot. So you may get the screen, and here you can create new you can create more quiz programs. So now we can create. Here you can see the label called create. When you press that, you will be getting the other window. You can create new Kahoot. You just press create. Now it shows some format. Here you can add your questions and you can give your answers. You can fix the limitations, time limitation. You can fix the points, and even you can add the images, add the links. So these can be done here. Let me see how we are creating this quiz program. So let us start with a simple question. Just we'll start with the mathematics, simple mathematics, addition or anything else. So here we'll start with some addition. 8 plus 12 is equal to. And you can fix the time limit also. See, this Kahoot, which helps us the students from the lower age to the upper age people. There is no limitations for the age. See, just type your question and you can press and change the time limit. Here the time limits were shown. I just give 10 seconds. Next, we can fix the points also. Now you can see sometimes the objective type questions may have multiple answers also. So here single select, and you can change it as multi select also. Okay, so in this area you can add your images, or else you can upload some images, even you can give some Google videos also, sorry, YouTube videos also here. Just we'll type the answer. So I'll start with some, it's wrong, so we don't want to click it. And next, this may be the right answer, then you have to fix it. It's very simple. Okay, so first question is ready and we are moving for the next question. If you want to add the next question, just press add question. Again, the question is added. See here, we can have objective type questions, descriptive type questions. All the questions may be added here. That is why when we press add questions, there are so many options were shown here. It may be a quiz, true or false, open ended, puzzles, polo, word cloud, slide. So these are the various methods of raising a questions. So now we can go for the, which is the capital of India. Again, you can change the seconds. Here, single selection. And we'll start with the answers. So answer, you can fix it. Okay, like this we have to add more questions and you can complete this one. Now after adding the questions, you have to press done. Here, see, in the top of the web page you may find some label buttons, preview, exit. You can preview, you can see that what you have done. After that, you can press done. You can give the title for this. And you can give the description also. So now the Kahoot will validate. Okay, now you can see what are the types of games you have created with using questions. Here it will be displayed. Let us play. See, there is a difference between other applications and the Kahoot. Kahoot will give a different appearance of all the quiz programs. Let us see how it is working. You can teach or you can assign. I'll tell you how to assign to other students. See, when you are assigning the challenges, you can fix the time target to the students also, that it's shown here, and you can fix the time, date, time for the completion of this one, question timer, randomized answer order. If you press off, they could not answer in randomized. And if you press the button of off for nickname generator, then they could not create any nickname. And here is the limit. So since it is a paid application, we are using the trial version of this, so that there is a limitation of participants. When you go for paid, or when we go for licensed one, then we can extend the limitations of the user. So already we have assigned. Just a minute. So now you have to copy this URL. So URL will be displayed. Please copy this URL. This can be shared to all of your students. So you can give the nickname. The students can give the nickname. So the title is displaying, and see that how interactively the quiz is organized. So now the questions are displaying. If we are adding some video, the video will be playing. So when they try to answer these questions, so let us start with the right answer. Correct. And there is a button will be displayed to move on to the next. For each question, it will be showing the scores also. So when I'm pressing a wrong answer, answer is stripped out. See, this application plays this quiz program with pleasant musics. You can add the musics. It will be it will create more enthusiasm for the students. So this is about your Kahoot. So Kahoot helps us to create more assessment questions. See, there are many options are available. You can organize these questions in a organized folder also. This is about your Kahoot. It is very simple to learn and use this Kahoot application, and it will be more interesting. And if we add more videos, more images, even sometimes we can add our lectures, then you can post the question. This is the additional features available in Kahoot. If we are taking some recorded lectures, the lectures can be posted based on the video. They can answer the questions. This can also be done with the help of Kahoot. Next. I hope you understand and the accessing methods of Kahoot. Next, we'll look off WebEx. So just go to the Google and just type WebEx. WebEx is a Cisco product. Here you can find meetings. It's similar to our Zoom and Google app. You can download the apps. Already I have downloaded. And see, this is the screen will be appearing in Cisco WebEx meeting. We can start our meeting, we can schedule a meeting and join the meeting. All are possible. When you press start meeting, so meeting will be start. So here there are multiple options were available. It's like a word process. Open and share control. We can share the documents as like we are using in Google Meet. You can mute your mic or switch on your mic. You can, by pressing this button, you can add your videos, and this is useful. This icon is used to share your documents, and even we can record this document. We can close the participants when, and there is a chat facilities also available. We can lock the meeting in the sense that meeting will be only for the specified participants, and you can create meeting link. Even we can connect to other devices, such as if we have smart TV or other devices like mobile with laptops, it is very easy to connect the documents. So this is about your WebEx. This WebEx is useful to conduct the classes. and you can here you can limit the participants and restrict the participants. It is without any say we have some passwords as like your Google Google meeting. Here also we can use some passwords and we can limit and restrict the participants. So the chat box will be appear here. You can chat with the people who are all joining in this. Okay, fine. Today we have discussed about two applications. One is Kahoot, the other one is WebEx. The Kahoot is an application we can create interactive quiz programs, interactive assessment process. Even we can load our videos, we can conduct our classes in Kahoot. But the Kahoot is having one restriction. We have to get the license to do all the thing. And this, especially this interactive creation of interactive quiz program or quiz questionnaires is very, very much free. Since we are using the trial version, this may not be it can be upgraded with the help of our with getting the license. I hope that all can get some ideas on Kahoot and WebEx. So Kahoot, which helps us the students with more interactive attending with more interactive assessments. It is very simple to create questions. You can get into the Kahoot application and you can create your own questionnaires and you can share the questionnaires to your students, and it will be amazing. Just try with a few sample questions on your subject. And next, you can use your WebEx because it is highly secured. You know very well nowadays our Indian government restricted few apps which is connected with our Chinese product, so that WebEx helps us to teach our students online. I hope I have done the today's session. So today's session we discussed about LMS, learning management system, and what is e